The suspended head of the Philippine Energy Regulator vows to fight her preventive suspension by the ombudsman. Mona Lisa Di Malanta on Monday said her reputation is at stake. She also objected to going without pay for 6 months. The government graftbusters slapped a suspension against Di Malanta over her alleged involvement in power distributor Meralco passing additional energy costs to consumers without approval from her agency.
Pumabigat yung anim na ba na wala kang sweldo? Para sa isang totoong government official na walang ibang income, dinivest ang lahat ng interest niya dati para magtrabaho ng tapat.
Business groups have since backed Di Malanta amid her suspension. A statement of support, including by the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry, warned this could lead to disruption in the ERC's operations and affect businesses as well as consumers. Former Bamban Mayor Alice Go is grilled again in the Senate over her true identity and her alleged connection to illegal pogos. Despite piling evidence against her, Go maintains she is a Filipino and not a Chinese national or not Chinese national Go Hua Ping. Go also evading questions of senators on her claim of alleged threats to her life.
Are you Go Hua Ping?
Madam Chair, may mga kaso na po na final po sa akin po sa court, kaya hindi ko po siya masagot po sa inyo ngayon.
Hindi naman kayo mai-incriminate, simpleng tanong kung sino ka. And the addition, unless hihingi pa tayo ng executive session, no? Lilipat pa kami kasama nyo sa ibang kwarto para lang masagot nyo sino ba kayo talaga. Identity questions are within the purview of the committee. The Senate has a right to know.
Alam ko po, ako po si Alice Coco. At pasensya na rin po kung hindi po kayo naniniwala. Ako sinasabi ko, as much as possible po, gusto ko rin pong sabihin po sa inyo lahat. At sa mga magiging questions niyo rin po sa akin mamaya, may consideration lang din po ako sa safety ko rin po. Magsasabi po ako, wag lang po in public.
Go's remarks drew outrage from senators who accused the former mayor of lying. She was once again cited in contempt by the upper chamber.
Opening pa lang, nagsisinungaling na. Alam naman nating lahat na may mga ahensya ng gobyerno na nagbigay ng mga birth certificate at inamin na nila ng PSA sa mga dayuhan at kasama siya doon.
Sasagutin mo kaming ganyan, pagkataas mo kaming bastusin, pagkataas mo kaming takasan, sasabihin mo may death threat ka, tapos di mo masabi kung saan galing yung death threat mo. Hindi mo masabi kung dito sa Pilipinas o sa abroad.
You are only being asked about your previous answers to the committee. Please stop being evasive. Stop being evasive before this committee.
Go also claims she fled the country via a yacht in a port here in Metro Manila. Senators convinced Go to privately share through writing the name of the person who organized her covert departure. They did not publicly reveal who that person was.
You told us minutes ago, isusulat mo sa papel para mabasa namin yung dalawang taong yon or kung nag-iisang tao yon na nag-facilitate at may-ari ng yate. Do that now. You said you would do that. Amin na yung papel, Miss Alice. Pakikunin sa kanya.
Sen, wag niyo po i-ano po sa public po ha.
Wag niyo kaming uutusan, Miss Alice.
Pasensya na po.
Although cited in contempt by the Senate, Go will remain under police custody until she posts bail for her case in Tarlac. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. sacks Immigration Chief Norman Tancinco over the escape of Alice Go from the country. Tancinco's dismissal was confirmed by the palace as he attended the Senate probe of Go's illegal flight to Indonesia. Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Rimulya today said he recommended Tancinco's dismissal to the president. He also wanted the immigration chief out over the agency's alleged issuance of visas to fake corporations. The Secretary of Presidential Communications says this move is in line with the president's earlier warning that heads will roll over Go's escape.
Mensahe rin yan ng ating pangulo sa lahat ng nakaupo, presidential appointees in particular. Kapag hindi tumutugma ang mga gawain sa hinihingi ng kanilang mandato, ay may paglalakbay.
Pope Francis now in Timor-Leste, the third stop of his 12-day Asia-Pacific tour. The 87-year-old pontiff arrived at Timor-Leste's capital, Dili, Monday afternoon from Papua New Guinea. This is the first time a pope has visited Timor-Leste since it gained its independence from Portugal in 2002. Francis's schedule includes meetings with local Jesuits, children, and the Catholic faithful. Locals hope the Pope will extend a message of harmony similar to the one he delivered in Indonesia last week. Francis will finish his papal tour in Singapore before returning to Rome on September 13.